make notes on the tetanus. Tetanus, it is caused by the bacterium Clostridium tetani, and it is a spore-forming bacteria, and it is anaerobic and gram-positive and motile bacillus. And about the pathogenesis, and the basically Clostridium tetani is a non-invasive organism. The spores of the this non-pathogenic bacilli will remain in soil or contaminated tissues until conditions are favorable for transformation into the infective vegetative form. And this transformation basically occurs in the presence of locally decreased oxygen and devitalized tissue, in the presence of foreign body, trauma, crush injury, and suppurative infections. And about the toxins, there are two types of toxins, that is tetanolysin and tetanospasmin. And the tetanospasmin is the main toxin which is responsible for the manifestations of the disease. That is, it binds to the neuromuscular junction at the site of injury and then undergoes retrograde axonal transport. And then reach the presynaptic nerve terminal, where it prevents the release of inhibitory neurotransmitters glycine and GABA. That is, it binds to neuromuscular junction, then axonal transport, retrograde, then reaches the presynaptic nerve terminal. And in this, it prevents the release of glycine and GABA. These are neurotransmitters, which are negative neurotransmitters. So it inhibits the release of glycine and GABA, and that causes the uncontrolled contraction of muscles. And next, about the clinical features. They usually mainly affects the unimmunized and partly immunized individuals, and the disease may occur in various forms. That is, one is neonatal tetanus, second, generalized form, third, localized tetanus, fourth, cephalic tetanus. So let's see one by one. First, about the generalized tetanus. And it has an incubation period of approximately 8 days and range from 2 to 14 days. And it can occur, the disease may occur months after the initial injury. And the incubation period depends on the distance at the site of injury from the central nervous system. The faster the onset of the symptoms, poorer is the prognosis. And about the clinical features, there is descending paralysis, and with initial involvement of the jaw muscles, and there is spasm of masseters that can lead to trismus or lockjaw, and then involve the muscles of neck, back, abdominal muscles, and then later soon involving the whole body. And as the disease progresses, minimal stimuli can cause generalized spasm. And later can lead to death. And typically the sensorium is preserved. There is difficulty in swallowing and autonomic instability can occur. And this usually manifests with BP, blood pressure fluctuations, in the form of either hypertension or hypotension. And also the autonomic instability can present like diaphoresis, arrhythmia, and recovery usually begins after 3 weeks. And recovery from tetanus occurs by sprouting new terminals in the spinal cord, leading to relaxation of the contracted muscles. Next, let's see the neonatal tetanus. And it is a major cause of mortality in developing countries, and the pregnant women who are not immunized against the tetanus do not pass on protective antibodies to their babies. An infection results from unhygienic birth practices, most commonly when the umbilical cord is contaminated at the time of cutting. Symptoms usually appear by third day after birth. And never in the first 2 days, and rarely after the age of 2 weeks. Excessive unexplained crying, followed by refusal to feed, apathy, are the common initial symptoms. And the baby develops progressive feeding difficulty, becomes rigid, develops paralysis, may develop opisthotonic posturing, and may experience painful spasms, and the mouth is kept slightly open because of the generalized rigidity and due to pull and spasm of the neck, and there will be spasms of the larynx and respiratory muscles. And characteristically induced by stimuli such as touch, noise and bright light, and there can have episodes of apnea and cyanosis. Next, about the localized tetanus. And it is less severe and in comparison to the other two, and is characterized by rigidity and pain confined to the muscles adjacent to the wood. And may lead to generalized tetanus later. And the next one is cephalic tetanus. And it is a form of localized tetanus, and which occurs due to injury of the bulbar muscles. and it has a poor prognosis. Next, we will see the treatment of tetanus. Most patients require intensive care management and good supportive care. Airway maintenance, prevention of further toxin absorption, and relieving the clinical features like spasm, controlling autonomic instability, and may need antibiotics. Airway management includes may require intubation and mechanical ventilation, especially in severe cases. And if the infant gets frequent episodes of laryngeal spasm and apneic attacks or central respiratory failure, intubation is mandatory. Then next is neutralization of free toxin. Cessation of toxin, and it is done by the human tetanus immunoglobulin. Human tetanus immunoglobulin, and this is given either as intramuscular or intrathecal. And the usual dose is 500 to 1000 international units. And the antitoxin cannot dislodge the toxin already fixed to the nerve roots. Also, antibiotic will be necessary, like usually crystalline penicillin and or metronidazole can be given. And spasms are usually precipitated by the minimal stimuli, so try to avoid the stimuli. Noxious stimuli like touch, pain, loud noises, bright lights, etc. And the benzodiazepines can be used for the muscle relaxation and relief of spasms. Most commonly, diazepam is used. It can be used either as IV bolus or continuous infusion. And diazepam prevents further spasms by causing GABA-mediated central inhibition. And it also helps by reducing anxiety and promoting muscle relaxation. Then other agents which are used are pancuronium bromide, and autonomic instability is controlled by with the use of alpha and beta blockers, alpha and beta adrenergic blockers, and also IV magnesium. And about the prognosis, it has high mortality and the outcome depends on the incubation period, the site of injury, rate of progression of the illness, and the presence of autonomic instability. And prognosis is worse when the onset of symptoms occurs within the first weeks of life. And interval between the lockjaw and onset of symptoms is less than 48 hours. That is, lockjaw onset of symptoms to lockjaw is less than 48 hours, and high fever, tachycardia. And spasms, especially larynx, causing apnea. These can have worse prognosis. Next, prevention with immunization with the tetanus toxoid.